How to configure Project 64. To download this emulator, go to their webpage, this one right here, link in the fixed comment, and click download here. This will get you this standard installer. Then just run it like any other installer, just by pressing next, next, next. When you run it, a window like this is going to show up. And there is this little prompt asking for you to wait for 30 seconds in case you're not a supporter. So you just wait for it and click continue when it's done. Okay, the time is up and the continue button is available. Now you click it. Then let's set up this. You see this list of games here? You can achieve this effect by clicking File and choose ROM directory. Then you point to your games folder and they are going to appear here in this list. Before we configure the inputs, let's pick some nice graphic settings. I'm going to put this full HD, some multi-sampling, let's put some filter. I don't see my preferred resolution, so I'm just going to type it. I like to host at this resolution because it's good for me. I'll just keep the aspect ratio. You can change it if you wish. I like to use VSync. Some people don't like it, but it's a matter of preference, all of this. I don't think I need to change any of these. This is fine. Everything seems to be fine. Maybe if you wish some smooth filtering, then change it. It's up to you. And this is okay. Maybe this one, but I'll just keep it standard. This is good. This is good enough. Oops, and I almost forgot. 144Hz is too much for the stream. Most guests cannot even handle 60Hz properly. So it's useless to use such a high frequency, such a high refresh rate, even though my screen can handle that. Oh yeah, and one configuration I almost forgot. You come here to Options Configuration and you uncheck Pause Emulation when window is not active. Why? Because I want to do background inputs. I don't want to be forced to focus the emulator window to be able to play. I need the guests to keep playing, even when I alt-tab from the game. Okay, then let's configure the inputs. And as I'm going to configure this for Parsec Soda, let's run it first and use the Master of Puppets. Here we pick the Project 64 options and input settings. Good. I'm going to configure the four controllers. So let's do it. And if you like my content, don't forget to smash the like button, comment, share, subscribe, and check the bell icon to be notified when a new video is released. The first thing that's really easy to miss is this checkbox right here. Controller is plugged in. You have to make sure all of these controllers are plugged in. If you don't do this, they are not going to work even if the button setup is correct. And now we're going to connect the four puppets, the four virtual controllers we need for this emulator. We're going to map them to these four controllers here. And we will need the virtual pad for that. Let's move this a bit to the side so it fits better on the screen. And we are going to use the V-pad to manipulate the first controller. Okay, so we are going to use this first controller to set up this. We click setup and we start mapping up, down, left, right, and then stick up, down, left, right, and then C button switches like the right stick, up, down, left, right, and then B, A, and start, and Z trigger. I'm going to put at RB, R1, and then the triggers, left and right. I'm going to do the same for the other controllers, and I'm going to speed up the video. Don't forget, you have to change the controller here from 1 to 2. See? It changes when you click. So I'm going to use the second controller, and I'm going to speed up the video from now on. In case you make a mistake like I did here, you just keep mapping everything, and in the end you fix it like this. Because my mouse sucks. It clicks multiple times, it fails, so yeah. Sometimes clicking is not the best option. Okay, now I'm done. Everything is good. All of the controllers are plugged. They are working. Whoops, there is one mistake here. Right. Everything is fine. Everything's good. We are done. Then let's test it. Oh, and don't forget to click OK to confirm everything. And when you're going to map these puppets, don't forget to hide the V-pad when you're going to use an actual controller. Now I am going to run Super Smash Brothers, and make sure you don't plug your physical controller before running the game. You want to guarantee these four puppets are the four detected players. So first run the game, and then you plug your physical controller, like I'm doing right now. Good. Here it is. This is my physical controller. And if I press here, nothing happens. You can see I'm pressing the buttons and nothing is happening. Why? Because it's not supposed to recognize the fifth controller, just these four puppets. So I'm going to map my controller to the first player. And now everything is fine. It is working as intended. Let's go here. Versus. Then player one, working just fine. Player two, all good. Player 3. See? Player 3 there. And player 4. Perfect. All of them, same time. That's what we want.